Afro Svengali's, I have to check in with you to give you some clarity about a situation that came up a few weeks back. There was this frenzy swirling around and people just up and screaming and hollering and trying to figure out, oh my God, what's happening? I pretty much blocked it out because it was ridiculous to a large extent, because as usual, these freaks in and around the Umar Johnson sector, the only way they can get attention is lie. And I wasn't going to even address it. It wasn't even worth addressing until we had a subject that decided just to up and attack, breaking the culture of silence for no reason. And that's pretty much been what's happened with breaking the culture of silence. These unjustified, aimless attacks on her at every aspect of her existence and her family, how she looks, her skin tone. These were attacks that were initiated upon her, having said nothing about any of those who've attacked her. They attacked breaking the culture of silence first. So for the most part, we don't really say much about it. Sometimes, yes, because we know that those that do it have a specific goal in mind. They want a reaction. Specifically, they want a bantering right then and there. They want this to be, what is this, fake beef, rubber beef, whatever you want to call it. Not like Monopoly money, fake beef, like, those plastic food items, fake apples, fake oranges, and bowls. Now we have a fake piece of beef. It doesn't exist. But I wanted to address this because it also allows me to follow up on another piece of bullshit that was being floated around. And the common theme would be these unprovoked attacks on innocent people. So this is what I'm focusing on. And I'm going to let you hear this clip about somebody who had this unjustified attack on breaking the culture of silence. And then it also dovetails into another situation where there was an unprovoked, unjustified attack on my friend Gerald, and there was an intervention. So sit back, listen to this clip, and I'll return and explain more of what's going on.
What's good,
Hey,
Pillsbury? Why you
let's
coming
go ahead
for
and pull
me?
you up real quick, Pigsbury. What's good? What's good?
Hey man, what y'all, the show ain't even about me. What y'all doing?
Nah, why you come for me, Pills? It's me and you. What's up,
Breaking.
Pills? Why you come for me? I thought we was cool.
Breaking. Look, we is cool. Listen,
Nah,
bro.
we ain't cool. You ain't
We're
my
not cool.
friend. You was talking shit about me, bro. You was talking about I was built like this and
Breaking.
I'm a bitch. I was like, damn,
Listen.
I
Yo,
was
people,
crushed, Pills.
listen, bro. It was, and you know what happened? Yo, people's the one that attacked me first
Who my
by deleting,
peoples?
oh, anti them by deleting
Okay.
messages out my chat. So I just had to. I listen. I didn't even know you was gonna. I didn't even know what I was gonna say. It just
So I
happened.
had to catch a fade because you was mad at my
Man.
homegirl. So do you owe me an apology for just coming on me, or are you standing on it?
Did you see that video your girl just made about me?
That's not what we talk
Did
about.
you? No,
We
no, no,
talking
no, no,
about
no, no,
me.
no.
I'm not talking about
No,
anti.
no, no.
We talking
Did you
about
just
what
see
you
that video
said
your
about
girl made
me.
about? She was
What
even scared
video?
of my. She. Well, I still. Well, somebody. Listen.
But
She
what
even.
does anti
She
actually
scared
have
of
to do with me?
Listen. We
Why
know
you
what's
coming
going
for
on.
me? What did I do to you? You
Break.
talk about what anti did. Why you ain't going for anti? Why you coming for me? I didn't do nothing to you.
Oh, I did come for anti.
But why you coming for me? What did I do to you? Are you standing on what you said about me?
Did you see that video your
Are
friend
you
made about
standing
me?
on what you said about me?
Listen, that nasty heifer just made a video.
Are
Did you see
you
the video?
Pills? You're not answering my question, love. Are
Break,
you
listen.
standing on what you said about me? Yes or no?
Breaking. Listen, I thought you were standing on realness as a. Did you see that
I
video,
am
that
standing
nasty
on
heifer?
realness. I'm asking a very simple question.
Listen, I'm not even supposed to be up here. I'm not even supposed to be up here
Okay.
right now. I'm a y'all
Why
keep
not?
this show going. Y'all keep this show going.
Why not though? Why you?
No, you got to answer that. You came for me, Pills, and I didn't do nothing to you. I get you how you feel about anti. That's between you and anti. I ain't got nothing to do with that. That has nothing to do with me. I ain't never say nothing about you. So why are you coming for me? Like, what did I get you're upset with anti.
Right.
What anti got going on. But right. What does that have to do with breaking? Why are you coming for me? So are exactly, you standing Pills, on what you said about me?
That's yes all no? We really want to know, bro, is why are you attacking this woman because you got an issue with anti?
Like, listen, what did I do? I didn't do nothing. I never say nothing about you.
I heard what you said. Did anti ever delete a message in your chat room?
I don't know, but that's not what we're talking about. I don't know. I don't pay attention to that because I really don't give a fuck. Anti got free reign in my chat. She do whatever fuck she want.
Okay.
My chat's so got free reign. All my mods got free reign. Anybody that's a mod for me can do whatever fuck they want to do. I don't care. That's their job. They're the mod. But that's besides the point. You came for me. So I get your issue with her. That's between, again, y'all. But you came for me. Because I'm cool with anti? Like, what? Okay. Like, that don't even make sense. So what I'm asking is, that's okay, too. If that's how you feel, that's cool, too. But I'm asking you, are you standing on all the things you were saying about me? Like, are you, like, that's how you feel?
Okay, listen. Is anti and Leah's Martin the same person?
You're not answering my question.
I'm trying my best. You're literally
answering me with a bunch of questions.
I'm trying.
I asked you a very explicit question.
Did you see your friend talking to herself in the chat room last week?
Are you literally standing on what you said, yes or no?
I'm trying to see if your friend is crazy or not, girl.
Listen, never mind.
Is Liz Martin and anti the same person? Man, I'm getting up out of
here. All we want to know is, are you going to answer direct questions? Are you going to bitch out Pills? What you going to do tonight? Oh, he already dropped down.
Felt like I was asking a very direct question. Are you standing on what you said about me? He asking me questions about anti. That's my homegirl. I don't care who likes or dislikes that. It is what it is. If people don't like that, they don't have to like it. I don't care. That's not my problem. My issue with everybody got their own feelings or whatever. That's my homegirl. That's how I feel. I don't give a fuck how you feel about her. That ain't got shit to do with me. Are you standing on what you said about me? Yay or nay?
Exactly. I'm not even going to repeat the vicious, vile, abusive, and sexually harassing comments that person had made towards breaking the culture of silence. And the person said, because she's AFW, because she associates with me, AAS. If that's not some cowardly bullshit, I don't know what is. Just like the subject ran off the panel. I want to say something else about breaking the culture of silence before I go on. Breaking the culture of silence reminds me of, no, I wouldn't say reminds me, she is that person in the community, which we have all seen, who is the first person to organize any sort of opportunity to bring someone comfort. And among our community, a lot of times that involves children at school because their families can't afford clothing. Even if it's a school uniform, there are times when they can't afford to get the children's hair done. Their kids, we know, get teased because of their hair. As we know, any opportunity bullies have to tease kids at school, they're going to do it. Our children, our adolescents, our teenagers, doesn't matter the gender, they're going to find a way to tease them about their hair, about their clothes. And those of us who have worked in and around schools, you know there's always somebody who's leading the charge to get a child's haircut, to get clothes, to get food. There's always something, and that's breaking the culture of silence. And as an FYI, for those of you who don't know, her children go to exclusive private school. So we're not talking about the children at the school where her kids go. We're talking about children who live in the poorest parts of New York. She's the one that does their hair for free. She's the one that's organizing care packages. This is what she's done for the longest time. This is not something she just started doing. When I met her, she's always thinking of other people. If there's an opportunity, she's going to share it. So when I hear this shit that they say about breaking the culture of silence. These lies that have been recycled over and over from, let me see your handcuffs and her other demon. I just say to myself, I can't even fathom the amount of hatred that you would have for yourself. I'm not even saying it's hatred towards her because you don't know her. How can you hate someone you don't even know? It has to do with the source that is making up this information and lying about these kids that break in the culture of silence, abandoned on the side of the road that CPS and no law enforcement agency could ever find any trace of. And that has been considered unfounded and it will not be investigated again. But we know because there are those who so hate themselves and they don't like their lives. They want breaking the culture of silence's life to be like theirs. I want you to ponder for a second the origins of this lie coming from, let me see your handcuffs, and a co-demon. The concept of abandonment is actually a complex theme. It can mean many things. It could mean that somebody was born and they were given up for adoption. It could mean someone was born and they're put in a trash can. Alton Coleman, the serial killer, look him up. His mom put him in the trash can. I don't remember who went and found him or got him out of the trash can. Abandonment can mean death. Abandonment can mean that one or both parents decide they're just going to go start a new family somewhere else and leave the kids behind. Or one or the other parent decides to leave. I'm going to get bread and I'm never coming back. Or they don't say they're not coming back. They just don't return. Abandonment can mean a parent passing away. Remember, it's the perspective of the person who is speaking, who's on the receiving end of the perceived abandonment. Abandonment can be, you can have a parent living in the same city and they don't even have contact with you. Abandonment can go on and on and on as far as the themes and how it can drive certain feelings. I'm getting to a point, so just hold on. Do you all remember who the Ayatollah Khomeini is? This was the religious leader who took over Iran or assumed the position, the leadership position after the Shah of Iran was ran out and eventually died. When Ayatollah Khomeini died, I don't remember the year, I'll look it up and put it on the screen. There were adults in the street just wailing. His funeral was so many, just scores and scores of people. And one of the most common themes that was heard racing through the streets, crying, I feel orphaned. They felt abandoned. So again, it's from the person's perspective. And you got to really think about, what are the origins? What is the motivation for someone to come up with a story that someone abandoned children and it's a lie? Ponder about what experiences those demons had and why they would come up with something like that. I can tell you this much. It has got nothing to do with breaking the culture of silence. It is their lie that they made up for a specific reason. People just don't bring up things for nothing. There's a reason behind people revisit certain themes. The same thing, I don't want to go too far off, this whole thing about males' booties and dudes talk about other man's butts and obsessing over other men and turning around and calling someone else who's not doing that the gay one, or all these misgendering terms. But it's those who are coming up with these phrases that want to escape people recognizing you got the problem. If you keep coming up with this stuff, you got the problem. If you conjured up in your head that someone else abandoned children, what exactly is going on with those who are coming up with the story? That's where the focus needs to be. They target people who they perceive to be in a position that really doesn't even exist. In their mind, they want to be in the same place, which is why they target. Stargate was talking about this tonight in her live stream. I'm going to go for, oh, they're talking about this person, or this person is getting too much attention. I'm just going to start making up lies. And that's what they do. So this whole theme about abandonment, think about the origins of the lie and the people who brought it to you. And there's your answer. It has got nothing to do with breaking the culture of silence as far as somebody making up a lie about her doing something she didn't do. They just want her life to be like theirs that they find undesirable. There is no other justification for somebody just making shit up and saying they abandoned children. I mean, you just imagine this, anyone out there, any woman, any female, the same lie can be told about you. Then what? They're going to investigate that. They're going to investigate whether you abandoned some children. They're not going to just take your word for it. They're not going to take your family's word. They're going to investigate. So I would love to see when the time comes, because that time is coming, when breaking the culture of silence finally reveals her strategy for dealing with the slander. What are they going to say to whoever it is, whatever regulating body, whatever system that we are beholden to? What's going to be the justification for spreading those lies? What's going to be the excuse? What's going to be the rationale? It can't be free speech, because you don't have a right to slander someone. And spreading rumors and lies are malicious. Tasha K was the only one held liable, and her husband, for the slander and defamation against Cardi B. Now, again, I've talked about this before. There's some things that just can't be addressed specifically because it's in the legal system. Believe it or not believe it, you will know when the time comes. But I had to make sure I said this because it's really ridiculous. And nobody is going to expect a self-respecting individual to get up here and explain their life away. I mean, you would think the way these subjects are talking that they're on Breaking the Culture of Silence's bank accounts, so they could speak on how much money she makes. You would think that they're on the deeds and they're on the leases that she has, that their name is on her vehicles, plural, okay? You would think that the way these subjects are talking. Again, they want someone to be unhappy. They want their life, specifically Breaking the Culture of Silence's life, to be just ratchet and not worth living and horrendous, making up all this shit. You gotta wonder what drives someone to make this shit up about somebody else because they don't have any facts. I mean, listen to what some of these subjects say about Breaking the Culture of Silence. I wonder how they would feel if they really knew what she does day in and day out. Oh my goodness, you saying she has hatred now, and this is just a normal life that she lives. Always thinking about people, always concerned about people, and is known for this her entire life. So this is what I have to say about these idiots that come up here, especially this freak you just heard, thinking it's okay to just come up and just stay whatever the hell, and then start putting her under some inquisition as if she's going to react like this person reacts, like these other subjects react, when they know good and damn well they could never come to you and say, this is something specifically that AAS did to me. And yeah, we're going to get to this erasing messages in the chat. I'm going to make that, however, another video, because this is running longer than I anticipated. I do want to make one point of clarity. I'm talking about all of these lies that were made up about Breaking the Culture of Silence that were initiated by others. And for a while, she didn't even respond. This is long before there were these claims that she was attacking other people's children. Her whole existence was attacked. She was attacked as a mother. She was attacked for her skin tone. All these videos were posted, all these pot shots, all these direct shots, and nothing. It wasn't until she started defending herself that it became a problem. So again, this is long before these claims were made that these children are being attacked. You know what? I think it's interesting because this is how the Umar Johnson sector has always been. They've attacked families, they attack children, but here's the thing that so many ignore. They don't even want to talk about how it got started. They only want to focus on, oh my God, these people are talking about us. They cannot handle any type of reaction whatsoever, but they're so willing to say whatever the hell they want about other people. That's just not reality. If people want to open up their mouths and start talking about folks and posting videos and calling people all these names, wouldn't you think that it coming back to them would be something they might be able to handle? If folks can't handle it, they shouldn't start it. There are times when you don't even say anything and people come up and start talking all this shit and lying on you. For the most part, I'm going to ignore it, but I'm not everybody. There are some people who are going to ignore it, some people who aren't. They have different ways of dealing with it. But nobody can come up here and say that breaking the culture of silence started attacking people. The same shit that went on with Let Me See Your Handcuffs and her other demons. They were the ones that came up with all these lies and calling CPS and having her swatted. What is the reason for that? Because she refused to join in to attack Larry Reed. They saw that breaking the culture and Larry Reed had this minor dust up online, which they patched up that same night, but they don't have to come back and explain anything. So Let Me See Your Handcuffs was aware of that. And then she gets a hold of breaking the culture of silence and expects her to join in with these outrageous, unjustifiable attacks on Larry Reed, for which now the demon who started them is under $100 a day fine for violating court orders. So just because you won't do what someone says, they think it's a ticket to go ahead and try to destroy your life by spreading all these lies and rumors and putting your family in danger. That's what happened, folks. I could say so much more about this whole situation, but I think I pretty much said what I want to say for now. It is ridiculous to think that people who coming to YouTube to give information or just have a respite have to sit around and react and respond to every single lie somebody comes up and says about them. But there is a time and a place to provide responses, and this is one of those circumstances. Before I let you go, I'm going to give you a response to the other bullshit that this idiot was slinging around along with these other demons from one of my favorite movies. Be sure you don't touch that dial after you hear Buyer Beware.
You really let this girl ruin your life. Look at you. She really did some job on you. You know how fucking nuts you are? Look what she did to you.
You ask me that? Where do you get your balls big enough to ask me that?
Just tell me.
I'm not answering you. I'm not gonna answer that. It's stupid.
I'm asking you again. Did you or did you not?
I'm not gonna answer. It's a sick question. You're a sick fuck, and I'm not that sick that I'm gonna answer it. I'm not telling you anything. I'm gonna leave. If Lenore calls, tell her I went home. I'm not staying in this nut house with you. You're a sick bastard. I feel sorry for you. I really do. You know what you should do? Try a little more fucking, a little less eating. You won't have troubles upstairs in your bedroom, and you won't pick it out on me and everybody else. You understand? You're fucking wacko. You're cracking up. Fucking screwball, you.
What do you want? You're nothing but a fat pig, selfish fool.